Hello dear student, today we will learn second chapter of biology class 10, that is tissue, the building blocks of life. As you all know that tissues are the group of cells, and the second definition is group of cells that has similar structure or perform same functions. Cell performing tissue having common origin and microscopic study of tissue and their function is known as histology. One question arises our mind that plant tissue and animal tissue are same or not. Plant tissue and animal tissue both are different. First point to define it, plant tissue required little energy and little maintenance, while animal tissue required use energy and use maintenance. In plant tissue, most of tissues are dead in form, and in animal tissue, most of tissue are not dead in form. They are living. Today, we will learn plant tissue. Plant tissue. According to their cell division, plant tissue is of two types. First is meristematic tissue, and second one is permanent tissue. As per as the name, meristematic tissue means the group of cell which are young and active and capable of cell division. It means they can divide itself. They have dense granular cytoplasm and large nucleus and without intercellular space. Intercellular space means there is no gap present between two cells. And they have also lack of vacuoles and they do not store food material. According to their position, meristematic tissue is of three types. First is apical meristematic, second lateral meristematic, and third one is intercalary meristem. First, apical meristem, they are found in growing tip of stem and root and branches, which help in increase length of stem and root. It means with the help of apical meristematic tissue, plant increase their stem and roots. Second one is lateral meristem. They are found in side of root and stem. They are responsible for thickness, increasing thickness of the plant. And the last one is intercalary. Intercalary meristematic tissue help in elongation of the organ of the plant. It means with the help of intercalary, plant elongate its size. Now moving our permanent tissue. Now permanent tissue. Permanent tissue are the group of cell in which cell division capability is stop or going to stop. They are formed by meristematic tissue after when the meristematic tissue lost their cell division capability, permanent tissue are formed. On the basis of their function and performance, permanent tissue are of two types, simple permanent tissue and complex permanent tissue. As per as their name, simple permanent tissue, they are made up of one type of cell. They perform supportive and protective function for the plant. Simple permanent tissue, they are living cells. According to their function, they are of three types, parenchyma, colenchyma and sclerenchyma. First one is parenchyma. They are simple permanent living tissue made up of unspecialized thin walled cell. They are living, oval, rounded walls. Their walls are made up of cellulose which provide thickening to the cell. They are loosely packed, large intercellular space present between them. The function of parenchyma is they store protein, starch, oil and fat material. They provide support and rigidity to the cell of the plant. If chlorophyll, which is a photosynthetic pigment, if chlorophyll is present between their intercellular space, then parenchyma is called chlorenchyma, which help in photosynthesis. And if air, it means air is present between the intercellular space of the parenchyma, then they are called parenchyma, which help in float in the water. Now, colenchyma. Colenchyma tissues are living, elongated, with cellulose thickening. They are circular and oval in structure. There is very little intercellular space present between colenchyma tissues. The functions are, they provide tensile strength and rigidity to the plant. It also provides elasticity to the plant organs, and it provides bending of leaf and stem without breaking them. Now, in the last point of simple permanent tissue is sclerenchyma. Sclerenchyma tissues are almost dead cell. They are narrow with tapering end. The functions are, they provide mechanical strength to the plant and its part. They make hard and stiff end of the plant material. The main thing of sclerenchyma, the husk of coconut is made up of sclerenchyma tissue. Complex permanent tissue. Complex permanent tissue are made up of more than one type of cell. In last topic, we will learn about simple permanent tissue, which is made up of one type of cell. But complex permanent tissue are made up of more than one type of cell. They help in conduction of water and food. First is xylem. Xylem is also known as water conducting tissue in the plant. They are dead cells. Some of them are dead cell. One cells are only living. They conduct water in unidirection. It means from root to the stem. They are made up of four types of cells. First is xylem trachea, tracheids. Second, xylem vessels. Third, xylem parenchyma. And fourth one is xylem fiber. To learn this, all the name, we need to learn this keyword TVPF. It means tracheids, vessels, parenchyma and fibers. Now, we need to learn about the functions of these all the cells. Xylem tracheids are tubular, found in lower vascular plant. Vessels are found in side by side, help in conduction of water in the plant. And parenchymas are only living cell found in xylem, and they are living cell provide nutrition to the xylem cell. And fiber bind all these things. Now, phloem. Phloem is also known as food conducting tissue. They almost dead cell. They work multidirectional. They conduct food to the various part of the plant. They are also made up of four types of cell: sieve tube, companion cell, phloem parenchyma, and phloem fiber. To learn these all the name, we need to learn this keyword SCPF. S for sieve tube, C for companion cell, P for parenchyma, and F for fiber. Sieve tubes are perforated cell. It means the pores are there. And companion cells are found side by side, which help in conduction of food. Phloem fiber are help in storage of food material, and phloem fiber binds all these three cells. These help in conduction of water in the food. Food manufacture in the leaf and distribution of food takes place with the help of phloem. This is all about for today. In next video, you will learn about animal tissue. Thank you.